Fascinating Nouns Extra.
Here we are, A. Farrago. We're still talking here. Lots of incredible stuff. The Simpsons, one of my personal favorites. It's been on almost as long as I've been alive.
Almost as long as TV.
Almost as long as TV. Yes, this is insane.
You know, this is from 1995, and in my head, I still think of this as a later Simpsons episode. but, you know, it's now about 90 years in the past.
So sure.
This great scene where Homer can't stop thinking about Clown College, and he looks over at his family, and he's drifting off into Homerland and picturing them as clowns. Terrific episode.
Oh, I know someone who went to Clown College, so this is a real thing. And Homie was obsessed with it.
Here we go. This is storyboard art from David Silverman, who was one of the first people to ever animate The Simpsons. One of the first people Matt Groening tapped for the Tracy Ullman show. So Silverman.
Wow.
Brilliant director, brilliant storyboard artist. This is
Who Shot Mr. Burns?
Who Shot Mr. Burns Part 2. This is building up to the key revelation. I'm not going to spoil it.
He's already spoiled one thing. No spoilers are there. I know this is also 30
Mr. Burns
years
got
old.
Shot.
Right, he did get shot.
We know that.
So this, I want to jump on. I didn't know that's what this was. I waited. I remember the summer between the season finale, I think it was season 6, and this one. I watched that episode more than I've watched any half hour of TV because I wanted to solve this mystery. And here it is. This is part of the revelation. This is the pinnacle moment that I was trying to envision to solve the case back almost 100 years ago now, close to 100 years ago. Here it is. I'm standing in front of it.
Yeah, storyboard art. We love this. This is, you get to see... just how you don't think about this when you're watching, but you have to figure out every camera angle, every character, every layout, every setup. You know, you get to see the notations here that indicate, you know, zoom in, zoom out.
Mm-hmm.
So you get this tight focus on Mr. Burns as he's relating the story of just how he got shot and who's the culprit.
Right. I watched this over and over again because there was a contest going on. I remember trying to solve it, and that's why I watched this half-hour television so many times. What happened with that?
Yeah. The mystery was, you know, you're not alone in this. It was not solvable.
No one solved it?
Nobody solved it. They had an official contest where you write in Who Shot Mr. Burns, and as far as I can remember from what I've heard from the creative team, nobody solved it. It was a very unlikely suspect. So the winner, they had to do a random drawing. And the winner was going to get a whole Simpsons prize pack, possibly be animated into the show.
Right, yeah.
The winner was actually just a woman who loved entering contests.
Well, how did they pick her name?
She sent it in. They pulled her name at random.
Uh-huh.
Called her up. Turns out she's not particularly a Simpsons fan, doesn't watch the show.
God.
Unlike the millions of people who did enter.
They spent a lot of time, bulk of their childhood, trying to figure this thing out.
So rather than work out a deal with her where they animated her into the show or anything, I think they just wrote a nice check. We're not really going to do interviews or publicity or anything. We fulfilled our obligation. We picked a winner.
Yeah.
And that's that.
Unbelievable. I'm standing in front of a piece of history.
History.
You brought this to me. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thanks.